Hi students, myself Nilesh Kumar. Today we will discuss a topic from geography lesson. Okay guys, on environment. Let's see what all the things are there. So here is your introduction. Okay, in this introduction we will talk about the environment. Environment is a basic or major factor in our life nowadays. Okay, because environment plays an important role for all the living things. So from the environment, it is support all the kind of ecosystem. As you can know that what air we are breathing, that is also we are getting from the environment, and the water which we are drinking, that is also getting from the environment, as well as the food, that also from the environment. So our whole needs are fulfilled by environment. Okay, so on that sense we have to safeguard our environment. For safeguarding the needs environment, we have to know about the factors, what all the things are there. Okay, so as you can see, this is a component diagram of the environment. First of all, the components and the human made. Human made means what? Human made means whatever the things are created by the human being. As for you can say that like building, infrastructure, roads, railways, what all the things are created to fulfill our daily needs, that is comes under human being. Human made. And human being also kind of a component of our nature. Okay? Then the natural. Natural means the spheres. What are the spheres are there? Maybe you know that atmosphere, hydrosphere, lithosphere, and biosphere. All together it is called. Okay, let us continue the subtopic. Another topic is, so first of all, it is a combination of the natural and man-made resources, man-made phenomena. Okay, so all together, natural and man-made phenomena are called what? Environment. Clear? So while the natural environment refers to the biotic and abiotic component existing on the earth, so both biotic and abiotic components together we can call that environment. It's clear now? Next, we will discuss a subtopic, that is called natural environment. Okay, one by one we will go in subtopics. So first subtopic, land, water, plant, animal comprise the natural environment. This all together are called natural environment. Because this, all the things are created by the nature, that's why we call it a natural environment. Clear? Next, dear student, maybe you are familiar with the meaning of lithosphere. Lithosphere means what? The land where we are surviving or living. Then hydrosphere, the water body. Atmosphere, the gaseous cover over all the earth. And biosphere, altogether interaction, we call that biosphere. In detail, we will study on the next subtopics. Let's continue. So as you can see that, this is the first introduction about the lithosphere, and there is a diagram of the lithosphere also. So as per this statement, lithosphere is a solid crust on the hard top layer of the earth. So lithosphere generally, we can call this layer, okay, solid layer of the earth, okay, not an inside one, solid, first layer, where all the plants and living things are exist on the earth, okay. Next, lithosphere is the domain that provides the forest, grassland, land, and agriculture human settlements. So we all know that our settlements are totally dependent on the lithosphere. Okay, as you can see here. Next, it is also a source of mineral. Mineral is a very much wealth for us or precious for us. Why? Because our daily needs are fulfilled by the minerals only. Let us go for the next topic. Okay, let us start another subtopic, that is called hydrosphere. As you know that hydro means water, sphere means a layer. Okay, so hydrosphere, what all the water covers on our earth, water found on earth, that is called the hydrosphere altogether, water body. Okay, as per the information, dear student, the domain of the water is referred as the hydrosphere. Domain means what? Domain means wherever the water cover is found on the earth. Earth means earth surface. Okay, we are talking about the earth surface. So it contains a different type of water bodies. It's like a river, lake, sea, ocean, etc. So these all are the water body or not? So altogether it's called hydrosphere. So it is essential for all living organisms. Clear? Let's move on to the next slide. Here is the atmosphere, which is very familiar with you. Atmosphere means what? As you can see the diagram, these are the different layers are found. Okay, mainly it is called the gaseous layer. Okay, different kind of gas and different altitude it is formed. First thing, the atmosphere is the thin layer of the air that's around the earth. It is a kind of a gaseous envelope which covers the earth. Okay, and different benefits are also there. Let's see, the gravitational force of the earth holds the atmosphere around it. Because of the gravitational force only, these atmospheric layers are surrounded the earth. If the gravitational forces are not available, means then life also will be not possible, right? Okay, let us see the definition. It changes, the atmosphere product changes in the weather and climate. Because of the atmosphere only, whatever the changes are found in our climate. Okay, climate and weather. Maybe you have seen the our climates are changing, that also because of this atmosphere. Okay, as you can see, your different altitude, different layers are formed. First of all, 20 km troposphere, then above that, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. Different layers are having different importance. Clear? Then the next one. Now we came into the topic is biosphere. As you can know that biosphere is a narrow reliant contact between all the three spheres. Three spheres mean what? Lithosphere, atmosphere, and hydrosphere. All together, the interaction we call that biosphere. Why? Because the life is exists here. Plant, animal kingdom together make biosphere or the living world. As you can see the diagram, all three spheres are here, like lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere. All together it's called the biosphere. As for the information, it is a narrow zone of the earth where land, water, air interact with each other to support life. Because for the life existence, these three elements are very much needed. Okay? So in this lesson, we learn about the environment and their basic phenomena. Clear? So till here we finish our lesson. In the next class, I'll give you the different tasks based on this lesson. Okay, and the following assignments also. So please go through the lesson.